All right, meanwhile, Senator Mitch McConnell, in case you didn't hear, says the Senate lacked votes on a health care measure in these early stages. That is not a shock. Of course, it was an uphill battle. He seems to be stating the obvious. Remember that a number of senators have said whatever the House came up with, we're going to shelve, put aside, we're going to start from scratch. But remember, it's a 52-48 Senate, Republican versus Democrat. So just a couple of peeling off there means you don't have a deal. And he's so stating the mathematically obvious. House Freedom Caucus member, Congressman Dave Brat of the fine state of Virginia with us right now. Are you surprised he just put it out there like that, Congressman? The votes aren't there right now.
Yeah, a little bit, but I think they'll find when they try to start from scratch, they're going to have the same problem. So they may circle a little bit, but they may come home to our product and at least somewhere in that ballpark.
All right, now you're waiting on this CBO scoring, and as you and I have discussed, these go back to your professor days before you became this big international media star. that the CBO is not the best at forecasting stuff. That's not always their fault. They have to work with a lot of variables.
Right.
They're the only game in town. I understand that.
Yeah.
But if they score your measure or the measure that came out of the House adversely, it could further complicate efforts in the Senate. Does that worry you?
No, not really, because they scored the bulk of the bill up front, and we only added on improvements. And so if the score, you know, they were off by 50% on the enrollments under Obamacare, et cetera. So it depends if it's on the price side or the enrollment side. But that what's key is Art Laffer, you just had him on. He's one of my idols. The key is what's the dynamic impacts of the healthcare system on the economy going forward. That's what we got to pay way more attention to. Everyone just pays attention to this static Washington, D.C. government piece, and not enough. This is 1/6 of our economy we're talking about. If you don't move to a free market system where prices matter again and there's some transparency and you get to shop for products with your own buck, that's what matters over the long run. You can put in something that scores well. Socialism might score well. Communism might score well, but it doesn't work 20 years out. So that would be an error.
Do you worry, though, that we're building all these expectations into budgets as the budgets just get obscenely huge? I mean, we're looking at a $4 trillion budget the president proposed right now. As recently as 2007, it was $2.8 trillion. A few years before that, it crossed the $2 trillion mark. This is unsustainable. It's just unsustainable.
Well, it is, and it's unsustainable in law, just so everybody knows. The mandatory programs, Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, et cetera, used to be about 25% of the budget. Now they're 75% of the budget. In 15 years, those programs will be 100% of all federal revenues. So there won't be any money left for transportation, education, the military,
et cetera. Do you try to explain that, though, Congressman? Do you try to say, I mean, I always tell people, like, even if you were to tax the rich at 100%, just to keep up with entitlement spending at the rate it's going right now, just that, it wouldn't do. It wouldn't keep them going more than a couple of years. And yet, I try to explain, I show the charts, I do the Ross Perot thing, I even do my Ross Perot impression, which I think is very good, but it falls on deaf ears.
Yeah, well, another way to put it is, the Democrats right now are shrieking over, we're trying to save $1 trillion over 10 years, $1 trillion. We're $100 trillion light on those mandatory programs.
Right.
And the kids won't get any of them. If we don't fix these programs, Medicare and Social Security are insolvent in about 15 years. That's way before the kids retire. There won't be any system left. They get zero. So we're not talking about cuts to something by 5% or 10% from a baseline. Actually, most of these programs keep growing. We're talking about kids losing the major programs. And so on the Democrat side, they don't have a budget that balances even in 75-year window. So we need to work together with them, but they got to come part way with us on these programs.
Yeah, we just got to do the math. Congressman, thank you very much.